Hi, this is Uma Mahesh from Sierra Mons. In this video, I'm going to explain about the Dynamics 365 entity tax in the Liquid Core in the CRM portals. The Dynamics 365 entity tags are used to load and display the Dynamics 365 data, or use the other Dynamics 365 portal framework services. These tags are Dynamics 365 specific extension to the Liquid language. And the first tag is chart. The chart tag can be added the chart to the web page or in the web template. So if you want to display the chart in CRM portal on a web page, we can use this chart tag, and this chart tag can be written in the web page in the custom JavaScript or in the Liquid web template for that specific page. We can use this tag. Syntax for that, we have a chart and we need to pass the chart ID, and which view data you want to load it, that view ID, CRM view ID, we need to pass it into this tag. And the next tag, editable. And this editable tag, it will renders given the Dynamics 365 portals CMS objects as they use the front end editing engine, and to publish the content for the users with the content editing permissions for that object. So editable objects include the page snippets and web links. The syntax for that, editable page, whichever the page you want to give it as editable, and the type, we can pass it as a type is a HTML or a normal text. We can pass it that type, and title of that page, and we can escape is equal to false, where liquid colon equal to true. So if the liquid colon equal to true, that means in this content, whatever the liquid tags will be there, those tags also will be rendered. If you make it as a liquid equal to false, that whatever the liquid code you have written in that content snippet, that it won't be rendered as a liquid code, it will render as a text only. So next thing, editable snippets. So if you want to pass the content snippets data here in the liquid code, if we can use this editable tag. And next thing, we have a entity list tag. So if you want to load the entity list with programmatically on the web page through the liquid code, we can use this one, percentile entity list, and in the name we can pass the liquid entity list name, and this syntax for that, the percentile entity list name, and we can pass the entity list, and loaded in the below we can pass the data, and if that entity list tag we can should be ended with the end entity list tag. So the first syntax for the with the name, if you want a GUID base, we can pass the ID equal to that entity list GUID. And another syntax, so the if you want to the web page, on that page, whichever the entity list you added, that entity list GUID, if you want to take it and you can pass it the dynamically, we can pass it. Instead of hard coding, that page, whichever the entity list they have mapped based upon that entity list ID, it will take and it will load on the web template. And entity view, this entity view tag, it loads the view CRM view in the CRM portal. So we can load that view by name or by ID. The syntax for that entity view, we can pass the logical name of that entity, whichever the logical name we have, and name, that view name, what the view name we have, that view name we can pass it here. and we nest syntax for that search index. So search index tag also we have. So whatever the search search functionality, if you want to enable it, we can use the search index tag. And the query equal to support, in the query parameter, whatever you want to pass it as the here the text, and the page parameters and the list of the contents, we want to show it there, and the number of the results, if size is zero, then one by one that such results we can bind it. This is a sample code for that. And the next important thing is the entity form. So if you want to load the entity form in a specific area with the Liquid code, we can use this tag, entity form. So here we can pass that entity form name. So here that curly brace percentile entity form, that name colon equal to entity form name, and you can close that tags. Similarly, for the web forms also we have a tag, web form tag. It will fully render the Dynamics 365 configured web form by name or ID. So in the below syntax for that, the web form and name we can pass it here like this. So this all the entity tags we have in the Liquid template code. So by using these tags, we can write our custom components and custom dynamic data from the CRM entity to load in the CRM portal form. We can do our customizations with the Liquid template code. Thank you so much for watching this video.